Some observations, then I'm going to follow up with some questions. We really do appreciate the entrepreneurial spirit that you represent here, the enthusiasm and such, and yet there has to be some sort of regulatory scheme, as we said, to keep that playing field level and such. Maybe we don't have to do anything, but I think we have to watch it carefully. I mean, you've heard the argument about net neutrality, and maybe those particular principles and the spirit of net neutrality may be spilling over to other aspects of the Internet, which I think is a legitimate concern if you want to apply it to one of the aspects of the Internet. Maybe it's a good idea in the other, and I'm talking about search engines and the potential for things that could happen. I understand where we are today. The question is, where will we be tomorrow? There's a basic principle here in Washington that we adhere to, and that is that competition is a good thing. And I know at the present time, you know, we do have some the contemplated arrangement between Yahoo and Google, and the concerns that certain members of Congress have expressed, some of which I share, maybe not to the degree of others, but I think it needs to be explored. We've heard this argument before, that if someone is doing such a great job and they predominate the market, why not just allow them to continue and maybe even reach certain contractual relationships that perpetuate that particular dominance? We had this issue with Microsoft not long ago. I still remember a legal argument being advanced that, yes, monopolies are bad, but technology is so different today. It's not the same, you know, it's not your father's Oldsmobile, and that's true. It's not even around anymore. However, the principles remain. And there's no such thing, I believe, as temporary monopolies. We've had people in this particular field in the past advance arguments that we are the leaders. Technology changes so quickly that you're going to have temporary monopolies. I don't think temporary or permanent monopolies serve the American public or the business world very well. There's a contemplated agreement between Yahoo and Google. And in a minute, I want to get into what is organic search, and then what are we talking about as far as the ads themselves. Can a business subsist, exist through just organic searches? Are they going to eventually have to take out some sort of ads, and how is that controlled, and who dominates in that particular arena? But regarding that particular, not merger, because it's not a complete merger, but still shared services and such, and the potential there of what it might represent, because I'm trying to remember exactly if most searches, 67-68% are Google searches. I forget where Yahoo may be, another 12-16%, whatever it is. But I mean, when you put it all together, you're probably at 78% or more of all searches will be either a Google or a Yahoo search. But Rob Pegoraro, his column Fast Forward of May 8th in the Washington Post, Google's still unchallenged. And someone has always said it before, and they said it a lot better, so I'm just going to quote him. It's not that Google is some tyrannical monopolist that must be brought to justice. This company has come to dominate the markets for web search, advertising, and many other services fairly by providing quality products at a fair price, which for most web users, it's free. It's moved when others have stood still. Imagine, for instance, how limited web mail and online mapping would be if Google hadn't reinvented such a category earlier this decade. But that doesn't mean that I wanted to run away with the rest of the market. It's fundamentally unhealthy for any one company, even one that claims to have don't be evil, stamped on its corporate DNA to amount to the crossroads of the Internet. And I'm going to ask Mr. Rothenberg and Mr. Lent on your own opinions. I know, Mr. Lent, you've kind of already have an opinion of, let's see where it all goes. Should Congress be concerned about the market share that will be represented as Yahoo and Google obviously reach this agreement, or if Microsoft is successful in acquiring Yahoo? Mr. Rothenberg.
Mr. Chairman, all these companies are members of my association.
In that case, I should move on to Mr. Lee.
So, as you might imagine, I love all our members equally, big and small. I do think that there are legitimate subjects for Congress and regulators to look at, and competition is one of them. The only point that I would like to make is that the competitiveness of this industry, the dynamism of this industry, is unquestioned and unquestionable. We need to make sure that anything we do promotes just robust development of more content, more sites, more places that advertising can run. Thus far, from everything that we've seen, certainly in our own membership statistics, certainly in the growth of interactive advertising, and certainly in the evidence on this panel, we have a system that ain't broke at all. So I'd be very careful of kind of going across that bridge from research, inspection, exploration into regulation without just very, very careful scrutiny. I mean, the success of the people on this panel is based almost entirely on what we call the long tail of the Internet, the ability of these tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of small sites to develop, to sell advertising, to take advertising, either to sell it directly or to take it through through online networks. And that's where I think the this committee ought to spend as much time as possible, just assuring that that dynamism continue.
Question: Should the committee be concerned? I think the direct answer to that question is yes, of course. With any growth that's substantial, and then any dominance that's substantial, of course there should be concerns. The line for me, though, draws between concern and action, and I believe that there should be a high level of scrutiny on any industry, especially one that's important as this one for the future of this country. That this level of dominance should be scrutinized, but I have not seen anything in my 14 years and in the 8 years that I've closely been associated with following the marketplace, especially search and display, that would lead me to believe that Google is doing anything to take advantage of their market position. So I do believe that that it should be closely watched, but I don't think that I think any action would be premature at this point. And that said, somebody will build a better mousetrap. It always happens. This is an innovation-led business, and some small business will come out of nowhere with some great insight, some great intellect, and put together a better mousetrap. And that will happen. It's inevitable. It continues to happen. Whether Google will buy them or not is still up for grabs. But that will happen. And you know, very very likely that level of dominance with this fast-paced industry will not exist at the level it is right now, forever.
Okay. Mr. Carter.
Yes, Chairman, I have some insight on this. The analogy between Google, Yahoo, and Microsoft, I think is, I don't think it's too valid. And the reason why is, I distinctly remember the days when I first started using personal computers. It was back in the mid-1980s. And what happened is that Microsoft, I believe, got their dominance because of deals they made with the makers of the personal computer. So when I got my personal computer, I didn't have much choice. It had that on there already. The difference, though, between Google and Yahoo and the other search engines right now is that your constituents, Congressman Westmoreland's constituents, everybody out in America, they're voting themselves by their own action each day as to what works and what isn't and what is good for them. And that's my own experience. And not only that, there are still people out there who use many other different search engines. I have one of my own column editors in Victorville, California, who still uses Dogpile. I mean, many people in this room might not even know what Dogpile is. It's a search engine that still works. She loves it. There are people that still use AltaVista. I mean, there are other search engines out there. So people are voting, consumers in America are voting each day, and they're just like you want to get reelected, they're electing each day right now that Google, for the time being, is the winner. And I think you should let the people out there do it. And the best part is that it's free, meaning no one is compelled and no one is forced to use Google each day. So I think the consumers are talking to you and speaking to you right now through those statistics that, just like Mr. Rothenberg said, the system is not broken right now. It's going along just fine.
I also think it's important to add that never has there been a time when consumers have had a more active role in defining the marketplace.
Exactly. Exactly.
This is a world right now where social media rules communication and conversation. Consumers have a voice. Blogs are replacing mainstream media, as you all know, on a regular basis, and consumers have the ability to choose. And as Mr. Carter said, they've chosen. Yeah.